Huh. Looks like we got another game settings update this Tuesday for Black Ops 4. Let's see if they finally added prop hunt into this game. Go ahead and we got Hot Pursuit, Deathmatch, Alcatraz, Infected. I see all this stuff back, but let's go ahead and select that selected playlist. We got Infected, Endurance, Mercenary, Bare Bones, Deathmatch. Oh. Yo, what's going on, guys? Sinister Skater here. We had a game settings update for Black Ops 4 early today. It was believed that this would be the last day for any major update for Operation Grand Heist, as the operation is actually ending next Tuesday on PlayStation 4. Of course, two Tuesdays from now for Xbox One and PC. So it was figured here would be the last chance to get any big updates, big game modes, anything like that, features. We had Hot Pursuit added back, but that seems to be about it with this game settings update. So it looks like any major content or any major update, patch, whatever, will be held off until the spring operation, which should be starting next Tuesday, April 30th, right after Operation Grand Heist. So with that said, I thought it'd be fun to kind of go back and review Operation Grand Heist and look at that roadmap Treyarch gave us at the beginning of the operation and see how up-to-date Treyarch has been. We'll go ahead and start here. We'll start with this left side first. This kind of like overview. It's pretty easy. Everything is up-to-date. We have the new content. It's kind of like a summary of this update. The new content with Outrider. We got that blockout update incoming. Of course, we got that. We got multiple blackout updates, all these new vehicles we got for Hot Pursuit, the new blackout experience, which was Alcatraz Island. Amazing. We got that. Shamrock and Awe event in March. We got that. And then new black market items. We got a lot of new items and all the items featured, which is most important in this thumbnail. We got so that whole column gets a check. So let's hop over to multiplayer. So we're gonna go over the left column in multiplayer first, which is the launch week stuff. So Outrider, we got that. League play, we got that, and many updates throughout the season. New weapons, we got Cha-Ching and the Switchblade and the Rampage all at launch week. Three new weapons. The one thing we didn't get is the sniper rifle that they teased in a live stream demo, I believe it was. I think Vondahar was using it. He used the hammer as well that we got in the DLC later on in the update. I think it was Datamine that there's going to be a new sniper. I think it was like a bolt action, I think it's supposed to be. That has not been added to the game, which is not a biggie because the new weapons are listed under launch week, but it is kind of a gray zone because they did tease it in the live stream trailer. Maybe we'll see in the next update. They could have been teasing it for Operation Grand Heist. Technically, they could have been teasing it for a future, the next spring operation. So you can't really hold them to that. My theory, though, is that they were going to release it into a bundle during Operation Grand Heist, like they did with the Sledgehammer. I forgot the technical name. The Homewrecker, I think, was what it was called. But they saw the backlash with the Homewrecker and decided maybe they'll just add it to the stream in the spring operation. So we'll see what ends up with that. But we'll give the new weapons category a check question mark, maybe a yellow check mark. Because it's a little bit in the gray area, but technically they did fulfill what they had. So moving on, one in the chamber, we got that major tuning update. We got that launch week, and we got a few other updates throughout the season. Moving into in-season, Infected we got, Bare Bones we got. I love that game mode, actually. Prop Hunt is the one game mode that definitely fell through. We didn't get that, which is kind of sad, I guess. I really am not a fan of Prop Hunt, so I don't really care, but I know some people are. So hopefully we'll be seeing that at the beginning of Operation, the spring operation. I don't know why I keep calling it Operation Spring. The spring operation. Fracture, we got an additional new modes. I think we got a few. I know for sure. Thing we just got on Xbox today, we got Deathmatch Dominion, so that whole thing is covered. So out of everything in the multiplayer tab, we only really didn't get one of the items. So far, so good on the roadmap. Moving on to Blackout, the prestige system we got at launch week, the new locations we got at launch week, new characters we got. This is again kind of like the new weapons thing. This is gonna get a check question mark. We never saw Misty, which they showed not only in demos but also in some of the promotional trailers with all the other cosmetics we got with the Operation Grand Heist black market experience. So Misty we never got. Maybe we'll get it in next operation. It was teased and it was in the trailer, so you definitely know it's not just like they're teasing in a live stream. It was in the Operation Grand Heist trailer, so that gets a little check question mark. New Hot Pursuit game mode, absolutely amazing. We got that, and the new vehicles, we got the SUV, the boat, the Mustang, and the reskins of some of the other stuff with Hot Pursuit. So in season, we got the spring map update for Blackout. We saw the hardcore Blackout come. We had the new equipment. We had the EMP nade, Sparrow, Flamethrower. Might have been a couple other things I can't remember right now. But that's a check. The event redacted. Technically, this is a check. I don't know if this is supposed to be referring to Alcatraz Island, or if that's what the new Blackout experience is supposed to, or if these events refer to double XP events, or the map update itself. I don't know. I guess we'll give that a check question mark because it's not super clear, but technically they have it covered. And actually, as I was just recording this, Treyarch actually put out the patch notes for this update. It's pretty much everything we've been talking about. But I do want to say we're definitely not getting Prop Hunt this week because where'd that thing go? This sentence right here, and for all those Prop Hunt fans out there, see you next week. They also confirmed that next week will be the next operations launch. So there's that info. Back to the roadmap. So where were we at? Additional new modes for Blackout. I can't remember if we got any additional new modes. I guess we got Hot Pursuit and the Alcatraz mode, so I guess that's technically covered. Let me know if you can think of any other additional modes. Can't really think of any off the top of my head. So Blackout, they did a pretty good job. And then last but not least, we have to move on to Zombies. So DEFCON 5, that's a check. Gauntlet, that's a check. Ethereal Razor perk, that's a check. The new weapons, we got the new Switchblade and all that, so that's a check. Signature weapons, those were added into Zombies finally, so that's a check. Alcatraz Gauntlet, we got that down the line. Host Migration, we got that down the line. The new elixirs, we got the 5 new elixirs, I think it was, and like new talismans a couple of weeks ago. So that's a check. And then server pause and split screen pause, that's a check. So Zombies, 100% so far. Moving on to the right column, the last new Black Ops Pass content column. We, of course, got Lockup and Casino. We got the new Cosmic Silverback. We got the new Zombies map a couple weeks after the launch of Operation Grand Heist. So those are all check. Instant access to all the stuff we had previously. And so all this is a check. So overall, they did pretty good. They only fell through with Prop Hunt, really. And then we had the two teases with the sniper rifle and Missy that kind of fell through. But other than that, they stuck to their word with the roadmap. I guess it's not really the word, because the roadmap's just a projected future. It's not a promise or anything. But they did pretty good. In addition to all that stuff, we had the two new multiplayer maps, the free variants, Contraband Hurricane, or Hurricane Contraband, I always get it mixed up, and Arsenal Sandstorm. We got other patches. We had the, I guess you can call this extra content, the DLC with the Replacer Blackout skin. We had the Homewrecker melee weapon, new signature weapons for sale. We had the Mastercraft and reactive camos being added. We also had the return of the previous Operation Mastercraft reactive camos with the ICR-7 and the Titan. We had the free weapon crate, of course, that they gave us all. We had the Black Ops Pass free access kind of weekend, and then the whole free Blackout trial throughout the whole month of April. So overall, they did a pretty good job. I would say they only really fell through on one thing, which is Prop Hunt, which they said we're getting at the beginning of the next operation, so I guess that's fine. The only thing I'd like to see for the next operation for sure would be kind of improvements on progression and kind of rewards in Black Ops. I feel like the gameplay itself is I, in my opinion. It's not like I want to play it super much because I'm not super fond of Black Ops gameplay, but the one thing I would like to see improved in the next operation is going through and fixing up some of the progression and rewards to kind of give me reason to play when I don't really want to play, if that makes sense. Improve some of the reserve rewards, maybe give us some new weapon variants to grind for instead of getting it all behind a paywall or something like that. Contracts, introduce some contracts. That's one thing I definitely would like to see in the next spring operation. So that'll be it. That's the kind of Operation Grand Heist review by yours truly. So yeah, let me know what you guys think down below in the comments. Were you happy with how Operation Grand Heist turned out? Are you disappointed? Do you want to see Prop Hunt? Let me know down below. Also, let me know what was your favorite feature of Operation Grand Heist. But for me, it's one of the Blackout things. It's either the Alcatraz Island or Hot Pursuit. They're both really awesome game modes. I think I find myself wanting to play Alcatraz Island more, so I think that would be my personal favorite. But let me know down below in the comments. That's going to be it for this one. My name is Cinder Skater. As always, if you guys enjoyed, hit the like button, subscribe, and turn the bell notification on so you get alerted when all my videos go live. You know all that fun stuff to do. Links down below in the description, 10% off Control Freaks as well as Indie Dame Apparel. You can also find my Amazon Associates link down there if you want to help support the channel that way. But again, thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys on the next video. Peace out.